When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual. And I'd like to take this opportunity to go through a quick spoiler card from War of the Spark. Now, my career has given me kind of a unique perspective, mostly because I worked on one of these things for a good number of years, 6.5 years to be exact. So I want to kind of talk about the Silent Submersible. Now, there's been a lot of controversy over this card in particular because, you know, not only is it an artifact vehicle that can be blocked by a land creature, which is kind of a weird situation, kind of like an unholy armor cannot attach to a creature with a holy armor. And it's kind of the same concept. Now, I'm not too concerned that it's too blue. I personally feel that it should be blue-black in dimmer colors. But the other thing is that even though it's a submersible vehicle, it doesn't have any form of evasion. And it could die to a lightning bolt. I mean, we do train to prevent static electricity from coming down from helicopters if they're, you know, transferring cargo or whatever. But, I mean, it's in the water. It's insulated from things like that. And now I know we're taking logic and applying it to a fantasy world, but is that not what we're supposed to be doing? Like, now granted, with a vehicle like this, I can understand the double blue in drawing a card, because a submersible like that is depicted, it has windows, it has lights. Now, Alvin, I'm not sure if anyone's familiar with that submarine, or the Turtle, had lights and windows as well, because they were low-depth vehicles. Or Alvin, in this case, was designed to sink to the bottom of the Atlantic to search for the Titanic, so it needed the lights on the bottom so it could see things. So, this is what I used to participate in. A submarine designed for war.
Submarine
unit fire. Submarine unit fire.
Lower contrast.
100 yards.
Fire! Fire!
It's faulty, sir.
The dad must have been operating correctly if you remain at 94%.
White smoke has been fired.
Weapon yeah. Bearers, 268, no sign of turn back.
Runway level, 400 yards.
Brace.
Exploder on. Possible wildlife, 2-1. We got it!
This video you've just seen was provided by the Royal Canadian Navy YouTube page, and that was where I was in 2012. I was in Hawaii participating in RIMPAC 2012, and we were sent there to sink that ship in particular, to prove the platform worthy and capable. I subsequently went on to serve on Chicoutimi, but in the end, when it's designed for war, you're never going to see it. You're never going to hear it. It's going to come, it's going to deliver the weapon, and it's going to leave. I feel they should have designed a submarine that was more war-oriented, something that would launch like a magical bolt or something. But this is, after all, fantasy. Hi, I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable and CEO of TPS Gaming. If you liked today's video, feel free to drop a comment, click like, and subscribe. To be notified of the next upload or livestream, don't forget the bell. It's 2019, and we have a lot in store for you, with affiliations with the following. Inked Gaming, a leader in customizable gaming supplies, from mouse pads and dice bags, table mats, and binders. Use promo code THEFILTHYCAS at checkout to receive 10% off your order. As an added bonus, receive free shipping on all orders over $75. A portion of sales benefits the channel. and Everything Games, Langford's premium gaming and hobby shop, carrying everything from Magic the Gathering, Warhammer, Attack, Wing, Keyforge, and much more. Online sales can be found at www.everythinggames.ca. I would like to thank the current patrons, but without you, I would not be able to keep this lights on. And remember, shop at your local game store. They are the foundations of the gaming community. Without them, none of us would have a place to play. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual.